Good morning, everyone. Your morning weather briefing for this Friday, October 11th. I have no changes in my U.S. forecast versus what I presented yesterday morning. Temperature and precipitation outlooks for the next couple of weeks. Our major storm system in the near term is going to be winding down here over the next 24 to 36 hours. Probably some of your worst conditions overall, though, are going to be occurring during that same time frame in North Dakota, blizzard conditions during that period. Then looking at very limited amounts of moisture for later on in the weekend through a good portion of the 6 to 10 day time frame in a big portion of the middle of the country. But as we get towards the final couple of days of the 6 to 10 day period and into the first half of the 11 to 15 day time frame, that is going to be a period when I do expect a significant increase in rainfall once again across the middle of the country, as illustrated by my 6 to 10 and 11 to 15 day outlooks. Biggest cold going to be in the near term, obviously a lot of freezing temperatures over the next several mornings for western and northwestern portion of the Corn Belt. We'll then be moderating temperatures by around October 18th and into the early 11 to 15 day period. QPF discussion for the 1 to 5 day time frame. No disagreements with this forecast. Almost all of the precipitation that is shown for the Corn Belt is going to be falling during the next 24 hours before that area starts. About a week of very limited precipitation. Most days will be none at all. The big precipitation shown for North Dakota is mainly over the next 24 hours. Of course, it is heavy snow. Even tomorrow, though, and into Sunday, there could be some light wind-driven snow there. Multiple threats of rainfall make up the big rains that are shown in the mid-south and into the southeast. Those rainfall amounts may be overdone to some degree, but there will be some areas that get rains every bit as big as the map does suggest. Now for the day 6 to 7 period, again, we're going to be drying out the Corn Belt for this weekend and for a number of days beyond that. I guess I would not rule out some light rains in portions of the eastern Corn Belt as this period comes to an end. But again, overall, the dry weather that begins in a lot of the Corn Belt for tomorrow is going to be lasting through this period and probably one day beyond that before significant rains return by around October 19th. Radar estimated precipitations at 7 o'clock in the morning on Thursday. Relatively light rains in a lot of the Corn Belt, although obviously heavier totals across to Missouri and into southern portion of Illinois, where there has been some localized very heavy totals. And then, of course, as you get into the northern plains, all of the precipitation there falling in the form of snowfall. And we have already seen some heavy snowfall amounts. These are snowfall totals just through 7 o'clock this evening. I'll be getting out an updated snowfall map as soon as it comes out later on this morning, but these are snowfall totals through last evening. Anything in that yellow or light orange in that map would indicate snowfall totals anywhere from a half a foot to as much as a foot. So already through 7 o'clock last evening, there were some big totals already on the ground across big portions of South Dakota and into North Dakota. Early morning radar loop on this Friday shows that significant heavy snowfall still falling across a good portion of North Dakota here early on this Friday. To the southeast of there, pretty extensive area of thunderstorms working across eastern and southern portion of the Corn Belt and starting to approach the mid-south here early on this Friday as well. Temperatures yesterday, quite a demarcation between very cold temperatures in the central and western portions of the nation against some still very warm temperatures in the east. Note the 80 degree highs yesterday in southeastern portion of the Corn Belt, even a 70 degree reading as far west as far southeastern Nebraska. But note that places in western Nebraska yesterday had high temperatures that were just in the 20s. Again, note the big change in temperatures between temperatures that yesterday afternoon ran 20, 30, some places as much as 40 degrees below normal on high temperatures yesterday afternoon against the eastern Corn Belt, where a lot of places still had high temperatures more than 10 degrees above normal. 6 o'clock temperatures on this Friday. Again, the cold this morning dipping well down into the Texas Panhandle. A place like Amarillo has been down to 28 degrees this morning. The cold temperatures, sub-freezing temperatures getting into the far western Corn Belt this morning as well. Overall, I'd consider the cold this morning as living up to my own expectations. Looking at the forecast, there's your 500 millibar forecast for 7 o'clock today. Again, illustrating just the historic nature of the storm system in question. Again, a 534 decameter upper level low pressure system, even a 528 contour. That's a low pressure system that for this time of year, more than 32 decameters subnormal. Again, that's the upper level low pressure system that would be very impressive for the middle portion of the winter time. It's historic in nature when you consider this is still the first half of October. It's still going to be producing quite a bit of snowfall for today and tonight before just some wind-driven light snowfall amounts for tomorrow and into Sunday. Again, it's long been my suspicion that it would be today and tonight that would be one of the worst periods for snowfall in the northern plains, given the fact that snowfall amounts are still going to be heavy during that time frame, but it's also going to be during the same period when we're going to be seeing their winds reaching their strongest, and that is why we do have blizzard warnings in effect right now for north central portion of North Dakota, the same area where additional snowfall is going to be more than a foot during the period in question. There's your winter storm severity index from the National Weather Service. Again, anything in purple there, that would be the area most severely impacted by the heavy snowfall in the near term and all of the high winds. Again, that's the area where crops and livestock are going to be under the biggest amounts of stress from the storm system ongoing right now. Other big story in the near term, of course, is the type of cold weather that this storm system is bringing down. Again, we've seen temperatures below the freezing mark this morning getting down into the Texas Panhandle. It's going to be spreading eastward for today. Still some warm weather holding on today in eastern portion of the Corn Belt, but note the big area there of temperatures 20 to 25 or more degrees below normal for temperatures for today. And again, with that cold weather making its way eastward, we're going to be seeing a bigger area of the Corn Belt with temperatures below the freezing mark for tomorrow morning. The area there where I am expecting widespread sub-freezing low temperatures, that is the basically no change from the forecast that I've had all week long. Again, that general area has long been expected to see sub-freezing temperatures by tomorrow morning. I've added in an area to the south of there. I think that most of the rest of the Corn Belt is going to be seeing temperatures staying above the freezing mark for tomorrow, but in that light blue area, I think that we can see a lot of 33 to 36 degree temperatures and probably some isolated spots getting down to as low as 31 or 32. Now, again, beyond the near term, I think your bigger story getting developing for the weekend and into a good portion of the work week period of next week is going to be the very limited amounts of moisture that are going to be seen in the Corn Belt during that time frame. These are precipitation forecasts for just a part of that period from October 13th through the 17th. And you can see here from the various models that most of them are going for meager amounts of moisture or nothing at all for the entire Corn Belt area. And again, this dry period would even last for a day beyond this as well. So yeah, we've got a lot of the Corn Belt that is very wet right now, but at least we do have some good news in the forecast that the Corn Belt is going to be drying out for the weekend and probably is going to be staying dry for a good portion of the work week period as well. After that though, model consistency remains excellent this morning. That another period of very wet weather is going to be getting started by right around October 19th. All of the models again this morning showing a very deep trough of low pressure developing by late in the day on October 19th in western portions of the nation. All of the models also showing a big ridge of high pressure at that time developing further east. That's your classic trough west ridge east weather pattern that we all know, that is a pattern that produces big precipitation amounts in the middle of the country. There is my own forecast on rainfall. Probably your wettest period going to be coming up for around the October 19th through the 23rd time frame. That's the favorite area for the biggest rains, in my opinion, during that time frame. It is a forecast very similar to what I talked about yesterday. I think that a lot of the area in question can see rainfall amounts at least on the order of 3/4 of an inch to 1.5 inches, but probably significant areas seeing amounts on the order of 1.5 inches to 2.5 inches, or even a little bit more than that. Again, October 19th through the 23rd being in the wettest period in the time frame in question, I do think we'll probably start to see things drying down some again for late in the 11 to 15 day period as temperatures start to cool down during that same time frame. Looking at some international weather for your Friday, starting to see a little bit of rain and thundershower activity this morning in portion of Argentina. A satellite loop here this morning would show that most of that activity is in northeastern sections of Buenos Aires. And when we look at the radar picture here in just a moment, you'll see that same thing. There's the northern Brazilian satellite loop this morning, maybe showing some scattered rain shower activity, especially in Mato Grosso, but other areas not seeing much at all. Again, there is that radar picture this morning from from Argentina, showing some rain shower activity this morning, maybe some isolated thunderstorms in portions of northern Buenos Aires at this time. There's my rainfall forecast for the next couple of weeks. Like yesterday, seeing some wetter trends in the 11 to 15 day period for northern growing areas of Brazil. And if anything, I would call today's forecast is even wetter than yesterday's forecast for that time frame. For about the next week, we're not looking at much rain at all. For Paraná, Paraguay, and areas to the north of there, you can see for the 1 to 5 day time frame that a lot of that area is looking at no rain at all. And still a lot of that area in subnormal rainfall for the 6 to 10 day period. But it will be for middle and especially latter portion of the 6 to 10 day period and into the 11 to 15 day time frame that we'll start to see some rainfall returning to the area in question. And again, there you can see in my 11 to 15 day forecast that I have introduced some above normal rainfall in some of the northern growing areas of Brazil for that period. For more southern growing areas of Brazil, they'll be dry in Rio Grande do Sul for a couple more days. I'll start to see some rainfall moving back into that area for Sunday, Monday, and then their wettest time frame will be for the 6 to 10 day period before they dry out again for the 11 to 15 day period. Rio Grande do Sul overall for the next couple of weeks should see some big rains on the order of 3 to 6 inches. In Argentina, easily the biggest rains are going to be for the 1 to 5 day time frame, more limited amounts for the 6 to 10 and 11 to 15 day periods. Still looking at below normal rainfall for the next couple of weeks for La Pampa and far southwestern sections of Buenos Aires. There's your week one rainfall forecast for Brazil from the European operational model. And again, you can see that over the next week, very limited rainfall amounts for a lot of the central and northern growing areas of Brazil. Only in Mato Grosso going to be seeing decent rains during that time frame. And of course, during that same period, some big rains are going to be falling in Rio Grande do Sul, southward into Uruguay, and into northeastern portions of Argentina. Then it is going to be wetter after that. And there is the week two, the 11 to 15 day rainfall forecast, I should say, from the European ensemble. We'd not call these heavy rainfall amounts, but the 1+ inch rains that are suggested by that model, that is generally speaking above normal rainfall for the 11 to 15 day period for a lot of the northern growing areas of Brazil. Elsewhere around the world, still looking at a pretty dry forecast for the next couple of weeks for winter grain areas of the former Soviet Union, a lot of below normal rainfall there. Forecast has gone cooler, still a lot of warmth there for week one, but a cooler trend in today's forecast for week two. A rainfall on either side of normal for the next couple of weeks in Europe, your biggest amounts in France, which is probably the area that would most appreciate the rainfall right now. Lots of above normal temperatures in Europe for the next 2 weeks. In China, mostly below normal rainfall for the North China Plain for the next 2 weeks. Near normal rainfall in Manchuria, most of that rainfall in Manchuria coming up for week two. In Australia, it's not a completely dry forecast. There will be some rain, especially in the near term for a small portion of Western Australia, even smaller portions of the wheat areas and further east. But you can see from this map that we're still looking at big portions of the wheat areas of Australia, both in the west and in the east, running subnormal on rainfall. Could very well be getting to the point where it's getting a little bit too late in the growing season for rainfall to really be having much benefit any longer on the Australian wheat crop. It's going to be a lousy wheat crop once again this year because of their long-standing drought conditions. And finally, for this morning, on the Canadian prairies, your biggest moisture for the next couple of weeks going to be in Manitoba and southeastern Saskatchewan. A lot of that moisture coming up during the next 24 to 36 hours. And of course, we're still looking at snowfall to be measured in feet in that period in portions of Manitoba. That's all I have for your Friday. Everyone have themselves a great day, an even greater weekend, and we'll talk to you again on Sunday.